Agenda item 20, report from the government.
Madam Mayor, can I move the report? Move the report. Can I just mention two issues which aren't within the report, but it's just helpful to keep that in here. One is on, I know members have a very keen interest in the issues of devolution. I have to say that, sorry, members are aware that authorities north of the town have been keen to pursue a devolution deal for those authorities north of the town, and their ambition was to seek to have a deal agreed with government, subject to public consultation, subject to the necessary policy laws for implementation in the year 2018. And I think that's safe to say that's clearly not going to happen. Thursday, Parliament rises this afternoon, and that's the beginning of the summer recess, and therefore there's absolutely no chance for us to have a Parliament deadline for public consultation. Certainly no prospect of getting parliamentary orders in the Minister of Defence Bill. I happen to suspect that it's highly unlikely there'll be any substantial legislation or parliamentary orders in front of this Parliament at all at any time. So it's unlikely to happen after the summer recess. Having said that, you know, so this is, you know, between ourselves, I think we have been successful in terms of getting this issue along. We did oppose, it said collectively, we should have left it there. I think at this point we are dedicated and committed to devolution, and we do want a robust governance model. We accept that. We will do some kind of robust governance in place. I don't think an all-meal in second was necessary. One party was a robust governance model, so I think we need to consider collectively what we want to see going forward. One of the things I've suggested within the Labour group, and I've spoken with the Chief Executive, is I think over the summer we need to take the opportunity to have a debate, whether through a member's seminar or whatever it might be, to just look at the issues again so that we can see how we can progress. Gate sets a vision of devolution. If the North Town deal does resurrect itself at some stage, honestly, I think we need to think very carefully about the prospect of having a two-party devolution to the south, and North Town devolution to the north, a joint committee arrangement for the Integrated Transport Authority, maybe County Durham doing a separate county deal, and Gateshead being left with South Town. I will say that more. So I just think we'll have some opportunity over the summer or towards the start of the weekend recess, have some joint discussion about that. The second point I was going to raise, just very briefly, I mean, everyone is aware of what happened yesterday. We've been working through this for some time. The only thing I would say is the entire project has been enormously positively received by partners across the region, from the private and public sector. I was meeting yesterday with chief executives and some of the politicians to do with cultural assets across the region, including, you know, the purpose of it was to meet the new chair of Arts Council of England. It was really nice to see them being congratulated by everyone about Gates' position and what people should be leading towards. So it was very positively received. What I would say is that clearly there was some challenges. I'm going to pay compliments and welcome to the approach that's been taken by the Liberal Democrats, because we do know, and I've seen some of the stuff on social media that says things like, I thought you had no money, and we get to explain to people to obtain capital expenditure, to invest, to bring in income. This does not take any out of our services, it's all investment in our future. I welcome the approach that's been taken. And I also think it's necessary to put on record why do these things happen in Gateshead? Are we just blessed? Is it just by chance of our geography, some lucky chance? I think it has something to do with the quality and dedication of the team of officers that we have within Gateshead. I'd like to put that on record.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. I've now cost keys off my list of issues to raise. I wasn't actually going to raise devolution.
solution. Expensive enough for me, I can do it on a monthly basis, but I will just add to the point that you've made. My view is that one of the key reasons for having the devolution settlement is to take control of transport. And if you effectively put a barrier right between the region, which is the town, then you make it doubly difficult to sort out your transport arrangements. And one of the key matters that we will need to address in terms of the keys is how we transport large numbers of people in and off the site once it's up and running. We'll be looking at well over 10,000 people at any one time needing to be on and off the site. Clearly having a devolution settlement that doesn't leave the north of the Tyne separated from the south of the Tyne, in other words, as one body, would be a much more feasible solution. And I hope that the idea of the north of the Tyne devolution settlement gets buried. Really do not support it. Clearly, I mean, my own view was that we should run ahead of the devolution settlement that was on offer. Just to take what was on and then we can then build on it. Clearly we're not in that position now. But yes, I like the proposal you've made that we need to debate this further over the summer, and certainly we'll be engaged with that.